Hi guys. So on Sunday we elected our new federal government in Germany, and the results had been quite up to what was to be expected. Actually, I made a short vlog while going to and from the voting thing, so I'll give you this afterwards. So the results, as far as the percentage of parties, it's quite up to the polls. So nothing really surprising there. But actually, there had been two surprising things afterwards, because first of all, the SPD, the Social Democratic Party of Germany, declines now to become part of the new government. So it's not quite true if this is maybe just a ploy from them to get more leverage, but it's possible that they won't go to government anymore, because it's really hurting their reputation at the moment. So this is the one big surprise, because most people are expecting to getting a new big coalition between CDU, CSU and SPD. The other thing is that the AfD, our new right-wing party, seems to be in disillusion quite even before they even take their seats in parliament. So they won quite a lot of seats, and this is worrisome. But one of their leaders, Frauke Petri, announced that she is not quite up to the party line, and seems to be another split off from the party. Actually, the original party founder, forget his name, did about the same thing in 2015. So yeah, it was, for me, it was quite the expectation at the moment is that the AfD will dissolve more or less in a similar way like the private party did in Germany, especially getting so many seats in parliament with a rather new and small party is not really a healthy thing for a political party in my mind, because they have to send really many people into parliament which are not fit for it. Just you don't have so many list space, and you get the people from back there, back in the parliament, and it's usually not a good thing. Same thing happened to the FPD a couple of years ago, when they had a really tremendous good result at the road, best ever in history, and afterwards they didn't make it in parliament anymore in the upcoming election, because they disappointed so greatly their voter base. But they made good advertising in the vote, but they stayed true to their political core, and most people didn't elect them for that. That's it was the problem for them. So yeah, I give you my vlog and my preliminary etc. in a second. Actually, from where we stand now, there are only about three up options. One which is discussed more greatly at the moment is the so-called Jamaica coalition, because of the party coloring. This would be the Liberal Party, the FDP, the Green Party, and the CDU-CSU. And this is not three, but four parties in the end, because CDU and CSU are the so-called union. The CSU is only going for vote in Bavaria, and the CDU in all other parts of Germany. And CSU is quite a problem there for the whole thing, so not quite sure if they can make a stable coalition for governing. Will be quite difficult. Other thing would that the SPD said maybe they are just doing a ploy, and maybe they are actually wanting to go to government and are just getting the leverage done. And the third thing is that we have to re-elect, which is not, if the AfD continues the course it has done today, which is maybe the better possibility for the big parties. But every option is a huge risk for everybody involved, because nobody knows how it turns out if we re-elect, and if this actually gives the radical parties more space, because people are even more disappointed with the established parties being unable to form a stable government. Yeah, we'll have to see. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll give you my Sunday vlog now.
Morning, guys. So I'm just Sunday morning walking to the German general election. Didn't talk much about it. Didn't talk about it at all. Mostly because, seems quite clear that we will have about the same government as before. I think the only thing noticeable or important could be that most likely the AfD is going into the parliament. It's about a certainty at this point. We get about 10% of the votes. And this is this party has evolved from a Eurosceptical and an anti-Euro party into somewhat of outright Nazi right-wing party in the last year. Probably mostly in the last year, last 1.5 years. But it's actually the only thing worth really talking about, because it's in that we will probably have the same parties in government, so nothing much will change. I think maybe some of the more reasonable things like free kindergarten or stuff makes it true. As far as I know, my luck, they will probably have free kindergarten when all my kids are in school, which is free in Germany anyway. So let's see how this turns out. Not so high expectations about the whole thing, but still voting is mandatory in the democracy for me, and so let's do it. So that was easy. Actually, we had about 18 parties to be able to choose from, but in Germany we have what we call a 5% hurdle, 5% cut. So every party which does not get at least 5% of the votes is automatically not going into the parliament. And this sounds a bit undemocratic, and many people criticize it that way, but actually it's a quite good instrument, because it keeps radical parties mostly out, as well as facilitates creating efficient governments. So many countries like Brazil or Italy or many others have problems to get stable governments. Israel, for example, is a very good example, where you have like they often have like 5 or 6 party governments, and this is quite chaotic. And Germany, I think there never has been a government with more than 2 parties in rule in Germany, as far as I remember. There have always been talks about the possibility of a 3-party government, but at last on the federal level, this has not been happening till today. So, yeah, it sounds undemocratic, but I think it's a good compromise, because there are many small parties. I think we will have 6 or 7 parties entering the parliament, and there are other 11 ones are left out, but they will also most likely only get a fraction of the votes. For many of them, I haven't seen any advertising at all.